evening. Apologies a little bit late coming on this evening. I hope you're well. If you're jumping on, you're going to get a notification I'm here. So I'll just wait for a couple of minutes to get some people online. So tonight, full body workout. I hope that we are doing well. Hey, Hannah. So just to set you up, if you're jumping on for the workout tonight, you're going to need one light and one heavyweight, if you do have one available to you, and then a small plate to use for a variation on an exercise if you have one, all right? We'll start with some mobility. We've actually got three supersets tonight, which means that we're only going to take two rounds of each of them. All right, so the recovery is going to be short. We're going to try and keep the intensity up, heart rate high, and keep your body working hard, all right? So I'll hang on just for 30 seconds, but I'll get started. I know I'm a little bit late this evening. I'm having bedtime issues at the moment. Or just sleep issues in general, really. I'm not sure it will pass. So we'll start with some mobility to begin with. You're gonna be at the back of your mat, all right? So if you missed the memo, you just need two weights, two variations of weights. So one heavier, one lighter, a small plate if you have one handy, but it's not a biggie if you don't. And then we've got three supersets of two exercises, and we're gonna hit two rounds of each of them tonight, all right? So you're gonna be at the back of your mat to begin with. So we're going to start with some mobility-based work. Take the feet just wider than the hips. And we're going to bend the knees lots to walk ourselves out to a plank position. So you're going to walk out to a plank. Hands are going to be directly under the shoulders in this position. Keep the feet wide. Take four shoulder taps. So one, two, three, and four. And then you push yourself back to stand all the way up. Beautiful. We do that five times. So walking forwards, take four shoulder taps. Four, three, two, and one. Bend your knees, push your all the way back to stand. We do that five times. This is number three. So start to draw the belly button to the spine. Brace the core to support the lower back. Beautiful. Two more of these. Warming the legs and the full body. And four. Beautiful. Let's go one more time. Some garage tunes on tonight as well. Kind of chilled, right, beautiful. From here, coming all the way down. Plank position, step your front foot outside your front hand, and then take a lunge twist. You're turning your top shoulder, keeping your back leg powerful, hands inside the feet. Step back to plank, let's take 10, other side. Long step forwards, twisting, good, two. Check the heel is down, front heel. And the knee comes far enough forward. So it's a big step. Good, this is four. And five, very good. 10 repetitions, yeah? Six. Seven, very good. Eight. Two more of these. That's nine. And 10. Alright, very good. So moving back from here all the way up to standing and just stepping wide onto the mat, taking a Cossack squat. So right leg is going to stay straight. Going to gesture with the left leg and step out to the side. Turn the foot out 45, sit the hips back, come down into a squat, step the feet back together. Do 10 repetitions. Two. So warming through the adductors and the inner thighs. Three. Great. Four. Five. So we're going to put a really big stretch in this leg. Push the back heel away. Six. Good. Seven. Eight. Push this knee out nice and wide. Nine. Let's go one more. 10. Beautiful. So step this foot to this foot. Take 10 the opposite direction. Good. One. Two. Three. Very nice. Pushing the ground away, four. Keeping the chest up and the back straight, five. Six. And for the stretch in the left leg by pushing the back heel away, 7. Good. 8. We've got 2 more here. 9. And as we finish on 10, stay down and shift your weight from side to side. 10 repetitions. Staying low and shift your weight from leg to leg. 3. Good. 4. 5. Good. 6. So sit the weight into the heels. 7. 8. 9. This is your last one. 10. Feet just outside the width of the hips. Come down into a deep squat to finish the mobility warm-up. Very nice here. So hands right to the center of the chest. Press the knees out with the elbows. Lift the chest up. Good. Open one shoulder. Take 10 twists. That's 1. And 2. So bringing some mobility to the mid-back, the chest, through the heart space and the shoulders. We need that because we've got some push-ups tonight, yeah. Good, 7. I think it's 7. 8. You're taking 2 more. Good, 9. And 10. Beautiful, okay. Fold the feet straight. Come just to a flat table to finish. Release the hamstrings. Chest and heart space goes forwards. Legs are straight. Lock the knees back. Yeah. All right, good. Roll up through the spine. We should be nice and warm. Yeah. All right. So we're going to get into the workout. We're going to take a first superset of 2 exercises back to back. If you have 2 variations on weights, you want to use your heaviest weight for this first exercise, all right? So 1 heavy weight for a squat and a high pull. I'm using a kettlebell. You can use a dumbbell, 2 dumbbells if you want to. Then we're gonna hit a push-up. And if you do have a plate, a small plate, you can use that to help this, but no biggie if not, all right? So we're gonna start with a squat high pull. So using your heavy weight for this first exercise, and we are going to turn the feet out, all right? So we're going to do that to be able to sumo squat, which means their knees are going to push wide as we squat, and it will allow us to get good depth in the hips and keeping our chest up, all right? So 12 repetitions here. Arms are going to be locked in the lower end of the position, and knees are pressing out actively. As you squat, lead with the elbows and pull the kettlebell high. 1. If you've got a dumbbell, hold it underneath one end of the dumbbell, and do the same thing. You might be doing the same thing with 2 dumbbells. All right, so your choice. Let's go. 12 reps. 1. 2. Now notice in the dead position, the arms are straight. 3. So there's no bend in the arms. 4. 5. Now keep the weight close to the body as you pull the elbows high. 6. Initiate with the elbows. 8. 9. Yeah, that's good. 10, let's go. 2 more. Explode from the floor. Control on the way down. 12. Very good. All right, move the weight to the side. If you've got a plate, that plate's going to go onto the floor. All right, I'll show you first. So try on your knees for this first set. So hands are going to be on the plate. Knees are outside the hips. And as you shift the hands off the plate, you're going to land into a push-up position, and then hands back onto the plate in between. Okay, so it's quite explosive. Aiming to land with bent elbows. Remember, elbows stuck tightly down to protect the shoulders. And then aim to push the ground away and hop back onto the plate, all right? So we're going to go here. Take the knees wide. My feet are anchored to the floor. 12 reps. 1. Arms straight at the top. 2. 3. 4. Brace the core nice and hard. 5. Keep your weight over the plate. 6. If you have no plate, just place the hands onto the floor. Okay, like so. Same thing. 7. 8. 9. 3 more. 10. Explode from the ground. Go. 11. Push the ground away. 12, very good. Rest. We're gonna rest just for 30 seconds tonight because we're only gonna do it one more time, all right? Very good. So there's push up, no pause. Go to the bottom range, explode, squeeze your chest, and push the ground away, all right? So round number two. We're gonna add repetitions in round two. 15 and 15 reps, all right? So 15 seconds rest, and we'll go again. Grab some water if you want, quickly. Sumo squats, high pulls. 15 in-out push-ups, all right? We're ready to go. 3, 2, 1, let's go. 2, push the knees wide. 3, push your butt right back. 4, 5, 6, 7, keep driving the knees out on the way down. 8, 9, 10. Stop the hands right at the mid chest, 11, not too high. 12, lead with the elbows. 14, one more please, yep. Very good. Weights down, minimal recovery. We go here again. In out push up, knees or toes. Now if you're on the knees, square the hips down, keep the body flat and strong. If you're on the toes, lock the legs nice and straight. We start on the knees, we maybe start on the toes and go to the knees after. Jump out, jump into the plate. 1, 2, 3, 4. If you're on the knees, keep the hips nice and square and still. The core brace as hard as you can. 8, 9, 10, come on, 11, 12, anytime you need, bring the knees closer under the hips, make a table with the body to finish the repetitions, yep, 2 more, yes, very nice, rest, they're hard, right, that's not my imagination. Explosive movement is great for cardio. Let's rest, 30 seconds. We'll go again. How are we doing? Did I miss anyone jumping on? So brand new superset coming. Upper body, lower body, okay? Second exercise, or second set of work, first exercise. A B stance squat, it might be new to you. And a lateral raise. Okay, so I'm gonna take 12 and we're gonna take 12. Now you might find that by elevating your heel from the working leg on the B stance will be really helpful. Now a B stance, ideally it's one leg working the hardest we can and this other foot is gonna act like a tripod. It's just there for balance, but it means that mainly we're pushing through the standing leg, all right? So the foot that is elevated is just there to give you balance while we train one leg hard, yeah? So we're gonna take 12 on one leg, we're gonna take 12 on the other leg, and then we're gonna hit a lateral raise for 12 on each arm. So I'm gonna use my heavy kettlebell for this, your choice. Heavy or lightweight, if it's a new exercise to you, just maybe feel out the technique first to begin with, yep. So in the B stance, this foot's gonna go slightly back and behind, turn the foot out to the side. 12 reps, so let's go, 1. 70% weight in the working leg, 30% weight in the B stance leg, that's 3. 4. 5. Doesn't matter if you're not elevated onto a plate. 6, 7, I'm focusing on my right leg only. 8, 9, good. 10, 11, one more. 12, beautiful, come down. Woo! That's tough, man. Other heel on. toes are down. The B stance foot, slightly back and out to the side. The knee's gonna push out to the side. This leg works hard. 12 reps. Let's go. Two, focus on the standing leg. Three, just the toes down on this leg. Push the heel down on the standing leg. Five, six, good. Seven, eight, lock the abs, lift the chest. Nine, 10, two more. Last one. Very good, down. Woo. Lightweight for your second exercise. Standing, lateral raise. So one hand down to the side. You're gonna extend the arm out to the side. 12 reps, one, two, three. Very good, four, five. Got the core in place, yeah? Six. Seven. 10 reps. Eight. Nine. Last one here. 10, good. I'll be honest, 8 kilos, slightly too heavy for me for that exercise. I might drop down to a plate on the second set, yeah? Hit the other side. 8 reps. One. Two. Shoulder height with the arm. Soft at the elbow. Three. Four. Lock the body in place. Five. Six. Seven. Good. Eight. There's no rush. Keep control on the movement. Nine, last one, let's go. 10, good. Down, time. Recover, good news, there's only 2 blocks of work, right? So a minute rest, we repeat one more time. 12 B stance squats on each leg, 12 lateral raises on each side. Remember, if you did miss the live jumping on today, so go straight to IGTV after this for you to hit the workout anytime you like, all right? So take 30 seconds, we're gonna go again. Changing leading leg. Started with my right, I lead with my left on the second block. Now what you need to know is, if your weight is front rack like mine is, you've got to focus on keeping the chest up and driving the knee forwards so that this exercise is quad dominant. You want to feel the front of the legs as the big working movement, yeah? Big working muscle groups. Let's go, position. Rack the weights if you're using them. 12 B stance on the side. Slightly behind, out to the side. Work through the standing leg, particularly. One. Two. Three. Brace your core really hard as you drop. Four. Five. Six. You should feel the quads bite, front of the legs as you stand. Eight. Good, nine. 10, do your best not to push too hard through the supporting leg. Oh, 12. Ah. Breathe. That's tougher. Because it's front racked and you're pushing the knees forward, your core works as a real hard brace as you drop. So you're gonna pull in and use these core muscles and power to push from the bottom of the movement. To the side. 12 B stance on this side. So the second and final block. Five.
Yeah, one hand. Two. Three. Bring your shoulder blades down your back. Keep it always close to your body. Four. Five. Good. Six. Seven. My right quad. Push your knee forwards. Three. Two. Go. Yes. One. All right. 12 lateral raise. I'm going to go slightly lighter to use my plate. Lock in place. Let's go. One. Two. Three. Just lock the wrist still. Four. Soften the knees. Seven. Eight. Nine. Two more if you can, yeah? Resist the swing. Good, 12. Ah. You should have seen the difference. Eight, I wanted to rock my body to enable momentum. Five, I could lock my body still and isolate the muscle, hit the back of the shoulder. 12 reps. Upper side, yeah? Lock in place. Out to the side, go. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Four left, come on. Nine. 10. 11. Shoulders are pre-fatigued, huh? 12, good. That's what makes that superset tough. The shoulders are pre-fatigued from the B-stance squat because you've been using them to keep your weight high on your collarbone. So they're pretty smoked already by the time you hit the lateral raise, yeah? Rest. Minute rest. We've got one more pair of exercises, yeah? You've got two dumbbells, you're going to use them for this. You've got one heavy kettlebell like me, you're going to use that, okay, for this. So it's a plank variation and a deadlift. So, not as wide as the sumo squat, but definitely outside the width of the hips. We're going to lift with a hinge. Okay, so it's a deadlift movement. You're going to deadlift the kettlebell. Step back to a plank position, lock your body in place, step back in, and then deadlift. Lead with the other leg each time you step back. Okay. So if you go back right left, you step in right left. If you go back left right, you step in left right. Cool? Lightweight after, seated, shoulder press, okay? So remember, more of a deadlift than it is a squat. Think hinge rather than bend the knees dramatically, okay? We're good to go. Start in a hinged position, kettlebell or dumbbells. If you're in dumbbells, they're gonna be outside the feet. Okay, for this exercise, you're gonna be stepping back. If you're in a kettlebell, it's inside your feet. Hinge position. One deadlift. Stay over the kettlebell, walk out right left. Lock the arms. Walk in, right left. Deadlift. Squeeze the glute, step back left right. Walk in, left right. Stay over the kettlebell. Squeeze the glutes as you stand. Step back. Right, left. Stay over the kettlebell. Squeeze the glutes. Step back, left, right. Lead left, right in. Put the hamstrings in the back of the legs. Notice the arms are staying locked. to initiate every single movement. That's six. Brace the core, squeeze the thighs as you step back. We've got four more. Stay over. Use the back of the legs, squeeze the glutes as you stand up. You should feel lots of grab on the back of the legs. Last two, one right, one deadlift, one left, one deadlift. Very good, down, that's 12. You're sitting down, lightweight. Be a plate or a kettlebell, legs are up straight. Rack the kettlebell or the dumbbell to your collarbones, lock in your core, sit tall. Brace your core as you press above the head. One, 12 reps, two, three. Now the aim is not to lean back at all. Four, in fact, slightly tip the chest, four is an inch. Five, you're gonna feel the abs work hard. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10, go, 11, 12, nice, rest. We're gonna go one more time. So to make this last set a big set, we're gonna hit 16 reps on the deadlifts and 16 reps on the shoulder presses, all right? I'm sweating tonight. I hope you are too. 30 seconds recovery, we hit one more round of work, yep. We've just kept this one really controlled and strength-based tonight, all right? So you're gonna get a little bit of plyometric work on Wednesday. If you're coming for the glute workout, we're gonna hit some plyos, just to train a different energy system, okay? Okay, so 16. Deadlifts with the step back and the step in. And the challenge is to stay right over the weight, hey? And to really focus on feeling the back of the legs as you pull with the hips through to stand up each time, yep? Let's go, let's do this. 16 reps, I'm gonna lead left, right. So lead with my opposite side. Hinge from the hips, tuck your chin to your chest. Pull the kettlebell through, squeeze the glutes. One. Step back, left, right. Step in, left, right. Pull the kettlebell. Tap the chin. Right, left. Right, left. Notice the feet. Mirror the kettlebell. They stay outside the weight. That's three. Four. Try not to look up as you stand. Five, it's something I have to keep reminding myself. Keep tucking the chin. Six, squeeze the glutes every time you stand. Seven. Yeah, nice. Eight. Nine. Brace your core as you set back. The abs are working so hard. Nine. Ten. Got six left. Five. Alternating the leg each time you step in. Four. Three. Two. Last one. Good. Very nice. All right. 16. Shoulder presses to finish, yes? Grab your weight, sit down. Legs up straight. Aim to not lean back, sit forwards, brace your core tight as you press. From collarbones. Above the head. One, two. Now very strict on the movement, three, four, five. Now work hard on the way down, six, seven, eight, nine, come on, 10. Got six left, five, four, three, two, one. Very nice. Rest.
All right, all the big bulk of work is done. You have to ask yourself, was the weight right for my workout tonight? It's actually gonna be better, isn't it, to use a heavy weight for 12 reps than to do perhaps more rounds of work, because we wanna keep the workout short, intense, but really effective, hey? So well done. We're gonna hit a little stretch to finish, so bring yourself down onto your back. Roll down, roll down. Hug the knees just into the chest, release off the lower spine. Arms wide on a T-shape, knees to the side. So good. Right, knees back to the middle. They go the other way, shoulders go the other way. Release for the hips and the legs. Just hook one foot up on top of the knee. Flex the ankle, reach underneath. Grab the hamstring or even the shin. With the legs in towards you. So good. Change. Made it, hey? I don't know about you, but I always feel better after I've done it. 1,000,000% better after I've done it. Great, all right. Hug the knees, roll up. Thank you so much. If you came in tonight, if you worked out with me, it'll be on my IGTV straight after. I'll be here on Wednesday night for a glute workout at 7:30 p.m., I hope. So take care, everyone. I'll catch you really soon. Bye.